everyone, it's Lisa from Canine Clips, and this is Milo, and Milo is a Shih Tzu, and he's one of my senior dogs that's been coming for 11 years, and it's time for his grooming today. He comes quite regularly. He already is bathed, so I'm going to show you the full grooming of the cut and nails and trim up of everything without any restraints and, of course, without any editing to the film. So, like I said, he's been coming quite some time, and I'm going to be using a number 5 on him today. So he has gone blind in one eye, and he's starting to lose sight in the other eye. So it's just something I got to be aware of. But always not too sure. He doesn't move around a lot because he can't see that well. So I have to just kind of hold him where I need him to be. But it does make him a little nervous to move around. Because you're not quite sure. Everything's a little fuzzy. Good boy. For being a senior, he's still in fairly good shape, but unfortunately his eyesight isn't that good, so it makes it a little difficult for him. I was just about to make him stand, so he did that on his own. Get it marked. So with all seniors, of course, there's a lot of loose skin. Just got to be aware of that. He's quite comfortable kind of leaning in against the wall, so I'm gonna leave him like that. Probably lets him know where he's a little bit safe there. So just gonna switch the blades, make sure it's nice and cool for him. Thank you.
against that wall there. I think it makes them feel a little more stable, so. And he's leaning against the wall, so we'll just help him out with that. I just gotta stretch a little bit more to reach in there. Nice boy. Give you a little bit more of him and less of me. So if you are interested in grooming, I do have a list of all the tools that I use in the comment section of this video. Please feel free to ask me any questions about the tools I use or any of the products that I use. I've been using many of them for many, many years, like these clippers. These clippers are over 10 years old and still work very just like brand new. So things like that I've put on my list there, where to find them. But please feel free to ask me any questions if you have any. Or if you just have some ideas for new videos, I'd appreciate that as well. All right, so I'm going to do his feet and nails and just leave him kind of where he is because he seems quite comfortable. He likes having his foot or something touching the wall. So we'll see how he does. And if he needs a little bit more support, I'll kind of push him. I'm going to say push him back a little bit like he's doing on his own so that he can kind of touch this back wall. If he needs to, then he can feel a little bit more. This way he can kind of lean into the wall. So I do utilize this little area. I've always had walls around. Always on the back, but I've never always had it on the side, and I really find this wall really helps me out. The dogs seem to like it, and I guess it just helps me a little bit more for where they can go. And although Milo's really good, there are dogs that move around quite a bit, so it helps me to keep them a little bit more contained. Trim his nails. Going to trim a little bit here. Okay, Okay, good boy. I'm actually gonna kind of shave up his bump area. I'm gonna use a number 10 for this. This is what I can get here. He's fully intact, so he's got all his bits and bites down there. So. Just get what I can from this side, and then when I move him to the other side, I can get him from the outside. Okay, so I'm going to try his face here. Let's see how he does. I'm going to try to lean in, so hopefully I don't block your view too much. Okay, but he's really comfortable in this corner. When I switch him to the other side, I'm just gonna slide the table so it actually touches the wall on the other side. Right now I have a little gap there so I can put the hair into the garbage. But this new table, countertop, I guess, is quite heavy, so it doesn't move when they move, but I can slide it back to whatever side I need, depending how comfortable the dog is. Good boy. You can tell he's quite used to me already. And he did come to me since he's 1 year old, so that puts him at about 12 or 12 and a half years old. We get to know each other, eh? He was always a good boy. A very calm and relaxed little guy. You don't want to turn now. Okay, there we go. His ears are actually really good. There's no real hair that's grown in them, so I don't need to pluck them this time. They look very nice and healthy as well. It all changes a little bit for the seniors. Some guys grow more hair in their ears, and some it stops growing, so healthy. Healthy looking. Okay, so switch back to a number 7, and I'm gonna kind of continue on here from what I can do on this side, and then I'm gonna have to move them facing the other way. Okay, good boy. All right, I'm just gonna move this back for a little bit until I figure out what's most comfortable for him. Seems okay there, so we'll see how he does, and if I need to move him more, I will. The snails here. Nice, got some puppies. I just gotta pause while I let somebody pick up their dog. So just hold on a second. All right, we're all back here. I'm just gonna trim a little bit, I see. Okay, I'm just going to use the number 10 here in the back inside leg. gonna add a little oil here. Last one. Oh, I see we got a bleeder. Alright, now I'm just going to take them down so I can put some clean off the table. Okay. Okay, we're just about done. We'll grab him again. So what I do now, I'm just going to quickly give him a quick blow dry. That just kind of gets rid of everything that's kind of all the little pieces left on them. Plus, it'll kind of fluff up the hair for me. And then I'll do one more quick cut, and then we'll be all done. All right, there we go. Just one more finish up. And even though I just did them, it'll still take a little bit off again. This just gives it that nice, clean, finished look. Plus anything I may have missed. I'm just gonna get in here a little bit. Okay. Use a number 10 out of there. That way it can get really nice and clean. There we are, all finished. So hopefully you enjoyed the video. Appreciate you watching it. And please comment, let me know what you think. And if you'd like to see something different in future videos. And of course, as always, hope you have a great day. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.